Hello children, welcome to the module Programming for Kids. In this, first of all, we will learn about a very interesting programming tool for kids, that is Scratch. And before moving into the details of Scratch, how easily we can learn it, let us find out what Scratch actually is. Scratch is a program, or you can say a tool, to develop a stepwise thinking, how to perform a task in various steps. We also can develop our logical thinking. Those who want to learn programming in future, they can learn programming techniques using Scratch. Scratch also helps in creating simple, fun-oriented presentations, or you can create interactive demonstrations also. And after learning Scratch completely, you will even be able to do storytelling. You can create short stories, interactive stories. So this is all we can do with Scratch. So let us move into the details of Scratch now. First of all, let us get familiar with the Scratch interface. Broadly, this interface, as you see here, has two big parts. On the left hand side, there is a stage. This is the stage. And on the right hand side, a larger part is called script editor. On a stage, you will keep all your characters called sprites, which will make your animation. And in a script editor, you can create your scripts, you can create your programs, depending on which, according to which, the characters on the stage will move or behave. So let's go more into the details of Scratch interface. So before moving into Scratch interface details, first of all, let us understand what are Scratch libraries. There are various libraries. By library, we mean collection of something. For example, there is a sprite library. Sprites or characters in Scratch are found here. They are arranged in various categories or various themes. You can select your sprites or characters from here and you can add them into your animation. Another library in Scratch is costumes library. Costumes are actually various poses or positions of a sprite or character. As you see here, cat has four different poses. Then dinosaur one has seven different poses. So costumes are actually different poses of a sprite. Let us move on to the next library. What is it? Well, next library is backdrop library, or the background of the stage. At the background of the stage, you can add various backgrounds, which are indoor backgrounds, outdoor backgrounds, castles, space, sports backgrounds, underwater. So various backgrounds are there. By default, if you do not add any background, your stage looks white, plain white. So you can add various backgrounds depending on what kind of a story you want to tell. Moving on further, we have a huge library of sounds. You can pick up various sounds and you can add them to your animation so that they come alive. Sounds of various animals, electronic equipments, humans, musical notes, musical loops, percussion, various sounds are there. You can pick up and add to your animations. We will learn in detail how to do all this. So these are the libraries in Scratch which we can use to pick up the things and add to our animations. Now let us see Scratch interface in detail. As you see here, at the very top here, this is the menu bar of Scratch. Then this is the sprite edit buttons. Duplicate button is used to create the duplicates of any sprite. You click on the sprite and its duplicate will be created. You click on the duplicate button again, click on the sprite again, another duplicate is created. This is how it is done. You can delete the sprite by clicking on delete button. and clicking on the sprite, it will remove. It will be removed. Then you can grow the sprite in size by taking grow button. Clicking on the sprite, it will grow. Similarly, there is shrink button which will shrink the sprite as you click on it, as you can see here. Then there is at the top here at the top of the stage start and stop animation buttons, green flag and red dot. These will start and stop the animation by default. Just below the stage, if you come down to the stage, all the sprites which are added to your animation are seen. This is your sprites panel. Just next to the sprites panel is your stage background panel or backdrop panel. Then we can add new sprites. There are various ways you can add a sprite from the library. We can paint a new sprite in editor. We can upload a sprite from computer file or any image, or we can click the image from the camera. Let us see, when we click on paint, choose a sprite from library, a sprite library comes up. You select the desired sprite, click on OK button, and the sprite will be added to the stage like this. You can arrange the sprite like this. Then we can paint a new sprite also. Click on paint new sprite button here. The sprite editor has opened up. There you can draw your own sprite as you like, depending on what all skills of drawing you have. Applying those skills, you can perform simple drawing and create a sprite of your own. Now, talking about scripts, various script blocks are there, which are arranged in various categories of the blocks, as you see here, motion, events, etc. These blocks can be dropped into the script editor, and you can create your own script by combining the blocks. As you see here, I go to motion category and move 10 steps block. I bring it into the editor, and as I click on it, you see Abby sprite is moving. So the block which is added here is working for Abby. So you need to select the particular sprite for which you want to write the script. Then coming to costumes tab, various poses of the sprite are listed here. You can change them, or you can pick up anyone which you use. We will see how in later part we'll learn how it is done. Then coming down to sound tab, you can create or choose sound from library, or record a new sound, or you can upload a sound which is already saved on a computer. Let's click sound, add sound from library. Various sound effects are there, sound clips are there in various categories. Select the desired sound, click on OK button, sound will be added here. This is how you can add the sound to your animation. Coming back to the main menu, you can click on file menu and you can create a new project, save the project, or you can open an existing project.